What's going on, everyone? My name is Sanjeev, and on this video I wanted to share with you a cool trick that you can do to be able to find trending topics and how much is it trending it by, right? So on YouTube, if you're creating videos every single day, every single month, you need to be going with the trends. And if you are not able to find the trend, it's gonna be very hard for you to continue to grow your channel, right? You might just put out a video, it might get a lot of views, but after that, if you put the wrong video, you might not get a lot of views, right? So it's all about getting in the trends and staying on the trends so you continue to get that momentum on your channel. By the way, if you're new to my channel, my name is Sanjeev, and on this channel I create videos about YouTube automation and also bit about affiliate marketing as well, right? So go ahead and like, subscribe my channel. It would mean a lot to me, right? So the cool trick which I use to be able to find trending topic is I just go on and I went and install this extension. It's called Keywords Everywhere. Right, so you can go and find this extension, right? And when you do go and get the plan, it's going to be like they charge like $1 a month. So to get started, just need to do like, I think it's a paid version if you want to particularly use it for YouTube search, right? But I highly recommend you to get the bronze package. You can see I got like bronze package, and just for the whole entire year I paid about $15, right? Which is not much. $15 is not a lot of money with the value that you're gonna get out of this tool, right? So how it actually works is like I still install this extension, and when I go to YouTube, for example, I want to make a video about YouTube automation, right? So I'll just type in YouTube automation, right, very easily, and when I enter, it actually comes up with like suggestions. Like, look at this. So I don't know if you can see it. Let me zoom in for a bit, right? So you can see how much searches is this particular search getting every single month, right, per month. And you can see this actual graph, right? Is this graph actually going up, or is this graph like actually dying out? Like, you can see this particular thing, YouTube automation channel, and you can see the graph going up, but it goes down as well, right? So you will be creating a topic, a keyword that you can find that keyword is actually trending now. If I just go YouTube automation, right, you'll see this actual volume will be going down, right? Let me zoom out for a bit, right? And you can see just the keywords, maybe I'll go AI, right? So you can see AI, that not much keyword volume, and the trend is going up, right? So, and when you actually go on that particular thing, you can just see the trends, like what's the actual volume, right? So this really helps out if you have tools like this combined with another tool that I also use is called vidIQ. And for example, if I see a particular trend going up, like for example YouTube automation step by step, right, and I'll look for that particular keyword on vidIQ, so that way I know what search volume is that particular keyword getting search every single month, right? And the keyword that I like to look at is something between 20,000 all the way up, and it's like low competition and very low competition, right? It's going to be like a gold mine if I can find a keyword like that, which is like trending up, and also the search volume is about 20,000 plus and low and very low keywords, right? So that way I know, especially if you have a channel that's like really new, you want to be focusing purely on search traffic, right? Especially in the beginning stages. As your channel starts picking up momentum, that's when you can just go broad and start to focus on browse, right? So that way you can get most amount of traction on your channel, especially in the beginning stage. And after you have do that, you know that your channel will go in the browse, and after that it's gonna go to suggestion features, right? But another trick that I use to also find trend is I just go to Google Trends, right? So trends.google, right? You can see a whole lot of trends. But for example, if I want to do a car niche, right? If I want to, for example, go into a car niche, so I'll just type in car, right? And in here I can also compare between different niches, right? So I can compare between different niches, see which niche is doing well, and I want a niche to be actually going up, right? So I did celebrity, I also did like gaming, for example. This is another good niche. So the search, I will actually change this to YouTube, right? So now you can actually see, so celebrity you can see is just not that much searches, but celebrity is just a broad word, right? But you can actually see the car niche is overtook like the gaming niche. So I'll actually change this to game so you can actually see. All right, so I'll change this to game. Right now you can see that game is like a very popular niche, right? And I'll also can change into like music. So you can see on YouTube the most popular stuff is music. And if I also change these trends from 28 days to 5 years, now you see the upward trends. So another way that I also blow up channel is I look for trends which is continuing going up, right? I don't want to go into a trend that is going down. So you can see like 5 years, this niche is just going strong, like gaming, cars, it's like continuing, right? But if I do like this one example, maybe I'll do some sort of game. So you can actually see the comparison. I'm just trying to think of like Minecraft. Okay, I know there's channels in Minecraft. So let's see Minecraft. So it's a green. So Minecraft is still good, but there's another game that actually was trending up, maybe Pokemon. Right. Okay, so you can see that this trend actually is going down, right? It's gonna go down like that. So that way, it's not going to be a good idea to get into a trend. Like if I do Among Us, there was another game that was like really popular back in the days, right? So you can see Among Us spiked up, but it just went down, right? So this is not going to be a good niche for you to start, right? So that's another way that I look for trends, especially when I'm researching to able to start a channel in that particular niche, right? But here's another thing that I want to share with you is if you, for example, if you're looking for ideas, I'll go to Incognito tab, right? And I'll just type in YouTube and I'll see which channels are actually popping up on Incognito tab, and I'll see if there's a faceless niche I can get into the trend, right? So like for example, this is one that I just saw, right? This is a faceless channel. So you can see how much views they're getting, 1 million, right? So you can see this is a perfect example of a faceless channel. This must be like a talking head video, right? But you can see this is how I actually also find trending niches on Incognito tab, right? So another niche that I saw was, for example, this is mainly like faceless channel, but this is a like another niche that you can look at, right? So 78,000 subscribers, but the views they're getting is most of the video they're actually doing live, right? So there's like live videos. That's how they actually blow up the channels. So this is how I actually find trends, and how I actually look for trend, and I also look for topics in here, like for example this one, right? So this is a gaming channel, but this is how I actually find faceless channel and also trends, right? So these are some of the tactics that I share with my one-on-one mentoring students, and there's like a lot of different ways how I actually teach how for them to able to find this sort of niche, how they can actually get into the trends and how they can actually blow up their channels, right? So because it's no point of you creating videos after videos and none of the videos getting traction, right? You need to be following the trends, and these are just some of the many methods I share with my one-on-one mentoring students. So if you haven't still got that results that you're looking for through your YouTube automation channel, I'll leave a link in the description. Just connect to me via Facebook. So once you click that link, the first link in the description, it will actually connect you to my Facebook page, right? So you can just connect to me here and you can just ask any questions. So just send me a message, send me friend request, and I'll be able to help you out with your YouTube automation channel. But again, if you have a YouTube automation channel, I can also look at your analytics just to give you idea like how you can actually also blow up your channels, right? So reach out to me and I'll be happy to help you out with that. If you're looking for a step-by-step training, there's going to be another video popping on the screen right now. So make sure you click it and watch it, and I'll talk to you in the next coming video. Thank you, and may God bless you all. Bye for now.